How do you handle YouTube closed captions when there are two, three, or more people talking in the video? I'll tell you what happens. A mess. But no worries, I have a Camtasia solution for you. I'm Naomi Skorzynski with the Top Shelf VA channel, your place for creativity and inspiration for business and life. Okay, the first thing to mention is I have already produced an in-depth tutorial on how to create transcripts and closed captions. Those methods work perfectly fine if you are the only person speaking in your video. The first half of that training is a good review of the various ways you can create the actual text file for your transcript. I've provided the link in the description below. What we are looking at today is what can happen when loading a text transcript with two or more people, music, and background noise. It can be difficult for YouTube to set the timings when loading the text file directly to YouTube. I'll show you an alternative solution using Camtasia 9 or Camtasia 2018. Let's first see what the problem can be by loading the text for one of my clients' videos. Let's get in here and see how YouTube did with the timings for the closed caption. I usually like to review this at 1.5 speed to save a little bit of time.
Hi, I'm Evelyn Gallardo from the Discovery Beach House, and I'm with Sabrina, our concierge extraordinaire. And thank you so much for joining us on our happy hour tour.
Okay, so far so good.
So here we are at the Ronnie's place here in Manuel Antonio, Costa Rica.
The intro bumper is still showing the previous closed caption section, so the time is off right here. Then it's showing the music notation with the next caption. So that's off and is going to have to be fixed. Let's see a little bit more.
Yeah.
Well, our sangria is not like a regular sangria.
Okay, it does well until we get to this section. Evelyn said here, Sabrina said yeah, and Ronnie said, well, our sangria, etc. None of which lined up where they should have. Let's go ahead and speed up to another section so I can show you what a pain it can be to line the timings up in YouTube. Let's put this back to normal speed. So we can see where Evelyn says Pura Vida is not lining up properly. We then have to go back to find the right place to stop, which can be tricky since we cannot adjust this waveform at all. It's hard to see. Okay, she said, yeah, right there. Yeah. And now I have to adjust it here by dragging this over to the left. Then I have to go back and drag the beginning of this one over to the left to match it up with the one before it. There is Evelyn's Pura Vida and Sabrina's Pura Vida and her cheers. You can see how it can be frustrating to do this in YouTube. It's hard to line everything up with the waveform, having to adjust the left and the right on every single solitary caption, because when you move one in YouTube, it will affect all the others differently. It's very frustrating. Well, you get the picture. Let's go ahead and see how we can do this in Camtasia. Before we get in there, let me mention a few points. First, I'm going to show you one way specifically, which I think is the easiest for creating what is called an SRT file in Camtasia 9 and Camtasia 2018 to load to YouTube. Second, I never render and load directly to YouTube from Camtasia. It's a personal preference. I always render out to an MP4 file and then load the MP4 file to YouTube. Why do I do this? By rendering it first as an MP4, waiting for 5 minutes or so, and then watching the MP4 on a different player rather than in Camtasia or the preview, I usually can catch something I might have missed. For me, it helps ensure I load the most accurate and close to perfect video as I can provide to YouTube. So with this tutorial, I will be using the MP4 file I had rendered out. However, you could easily do this directly in your Camtasia project file if you wish to do so. After loading the MP4 to the first track, I expand it so I can distinctly see the waveform. This is so much easier to read the waveform here than it was in YouTube. I click on Captions, then I click on the Add Captions button. A large text box for the captions appears on the canvas. On the track, above the first track which is holding the MP4, the caption asset appears, which I like to expand out to the full width of the video. I manually expand the closed caption asset here, but really, it's not necessary to do that. It's just a habit I picked up. It will expand automatically on its own. If you were doing this in your project file, simply add a track above where your audio is and add the captions there. Okay, go ahead and get the text file of the transcript. Highlight the text, copy it with Ctrl plus C, and paste it into the captions box with Ctrl plus V. Click on the closed caption setting icon here at the top, and then select Sync Captions. A pop-up window explains a little how to use this. 1. Your video will begin playing. 2. Click a word to create a new caption. Repeat until all text has been captioned. I want to make a note here for you. In most cases, when you transcribed your video, you should have transcribed with one sentence per line. That will help you in knowing when to click on the word starting with the next sentence. Try to click with a new sentence each time. Sometimes, if a sentence is long, I will click somewhere in mid-sentence, and after all the settings are made, when I am tweaking, I will adjust it then if I need to. For now, I'm just trying to click when I hear the word of the next sentence or mid-sentence. It doesn't have to be perfect, because you will have the opportunity to tweak everything once you're done. 3. Use pause and stop buttons to control playback. Go ahead and click on continue and the video will start right away. Up here, you will click on the word when you want the next caption to start.
Our concierge extraordinaire, and thank you so much for joining us on our happy hour tour.
So let me go ahead and stop this for a second and show you what is happening. As you can see here, what I have tried to do is click a word every time that someone is speaking separately or starting a new sentence. Now here's the thing. I clicked on stop instead of pause to show you this. If I had clicked on the pause button, it would say resume and you could easily just keep going. If you do click on stop, no worries, you're not stuck. Simply place your playhead where you want to start. Go back up to the closed caption settings icon and select Sync Captions again. Click on Continue. A message appears asking if you want to start at the playhead or from the beginning. Select at playhead. If you wanted to start all over again from scratch for some reason, from the very, very beginning, that is when you would click on Start at Beginning. For our purposes, we'll start at the playhead. The first few times you do this, it will take a little bit to get used to, keeping up with the audio and clicking, but it's a relatively short learning curve. Now, of course, you don't need to watch me do all of this, so let's jump to the end here. Now, what we are going to do is watch the captions with the audio and fine-tune it. To get back to the beginning of the video, I will click on Control plus the Home key. What I'm going to be looking for is to have 2 lines per caption. You can have 3, however, I prefer 2. I'm also going to look for places where the timing needs to be adjusted slightly because I clicked either too early or too late. I'm not going to go through all of these, but show you just a few quick examples. We'll listen and watch the waveform.
Hi, I'm Evelyn Gallardo from the Discovery Beach House, and I'm with Sabrina.
So we see here she starts with hours, so all I have to do is move this to the left. You see, that's much faster than it was in YouTube. I'm not having to worry about the adjusting the left and the right sides of caption. See, they are stitched together and move as one.
So here we are at the Ronnie's place here in Manuel Antonio, Costa Rica.
Here with the music, I want to separate this out into 2 captions. I'll right-click on the caption and select Split Caption. When splitting the caption, it puts the same text on both sides of the split. On the first caption of the split, I will delete the text starting with one of the special things. On the second half of the split, I will delete the music section. Now I'll move back a little and line up these captions appropriately by the waveform.
Here we go. One of the special things that I love about Ronnie's place is not only Ronnie himself.
Let's go ahead and do a couple more examples. Here's an example of where I want the sentence to end on the caption before it. I'll click in the caption, cut out the Ronnie by highlighting it, and pressing Ctrl plus X to cut it. Remove the extra line space by pressing the Delete key. I'll go to the prior caption and adjust the sentence. Then I'll paste Ronnie to the end of the sentence by pressing Ctrl plus V. Here's the place where all three were speaking. Remember that was a little tricky in YouTube? So I'm going to decide to adjust this so it makes a little more sense. I'm going to take Evelyn's here and move it over with Sabrina's yeah and indicate that it is the ending of Evelyn's other sentence by putting it into parentheses. This will indicate to the reader that both are speaking at the same time. I think you get the idea now. Simply go through all the closed captions, adjust as necessary to the waveform, and if needed, moving some text from one caption section to the other. Once you get used to it, it will get much easier and faster. Don't forget to keep hitting Ctrl plus S throughout to save the work you have done. Once you have all the captions the way you would like, you are only a couple steps away from loading them to YouTube. Go to Share, Export Captions, go to the location on your hard drive where you want to export the file to, give the file a name. As you can see, you are now about to save the file as a subrip captions file with an SRT extension. Click on Save. If we open the SRT file, what we will see is Camtasia 9 or Camtasia 2018 has timestamped each caption. This is what YouTube's closed captioning system will read. Back in YouTube, under Subtitle CC, let's go ahead and remove the previous text version I had used for demonstrating the issues of YouTube's automated closed captions when you have two or more people in the video. Let's get rid of that. Now click on Add New Subtitles or CC, English, upload a file, click on Subtitles file, browse and then go to the file on your hard drive and double-click on it to upload it. You'll get the warning message that uploading a file will overwrite this version of English, which is perfectly fine. Click on Upload. If you want to be on the absolutely safe side to make sure everything is accurate before you publish, you can watch it one last time. You can make any minor tweaks to the text on the left side here. It should be fine because you used Camtasia 9 or Camtasia 2018 to super fine-tune the timing, so you really should be fine. Once you are happy with it, click on Save Changes. That's it. If you have 2, 3, 4 or more people in your video, use your Camtasia 9 or Camtasia 2018 to get the most accurate closed caption SRT file possible. I'll have the link to the other closed captions and translations training video in the description below. You can watch the first half of that video to learn ways to produce transcriptions for your videos. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell to get more training videos on a wide variety of subjects. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.